Now we talk about lactulose. Okay, what is lactulose again? Lactulose is just an isomerization product from lactose when we heat the milk. Up to 1% of lactulose may occur in commercial evaporated milk. Why quite a lot of lactulose occur in this milk? Because this milk has been evaporated, it's been heated quite a lot. In concentration, they need to heat to remove the water, to concentrate the milk, and the longer time that they heat, the higher the amount of lactulose that may occur. And the conversion from lactose to lactulose is according to this process, just the name of scientists, the people who discover this reaction. Lactulose is weaker than lactose because glucose becomes fructose, as we already said. And lactulose promotes the growth of Bifidobacterium bifidum. So lactulose is a bifidus factor. Bifidus factor, if you remember, bifidus factor means component which stimulate the growth of good bacteria in our gastrointestinal tract, and then it can inhibit the growth of pathogen. In this case, lactulose can promote the growth of Bifidobacterium. This is a natural and good bacteria in the gut. And because of the name of the bacteria, we have the name of the factor, Bifidus factor. Okay, so sometimes they add lactulose into human infant formula just to have the baby digest food better. Lactulose is also used as a parameter to evaluate the thermal treatment to differentiate between, for example, normal sterilized milk and UHT milk. What is normal sterilized? Normal sterilized means you have to put milk in the can already and then you do sterilization. And normally you do at 115 degrees C for 20 to 40 minutes. For a long time, because milk is already in the can had a size, we need long time for the heat to transfer because the can, okay? And then the temperature is not so high. This is not so high for sterilization. But for UHT, then we do heat treatment of liquid milk before packaging. So we pump the milk into a heat exchanger, for example, then we can do at 138 degrees C to 148 degrees C, much higher temperature, but we do much shorter time, 2 seconds to 10 seconds, for example. The time is very short. So both these treatments have similar destruction of microorganism. You destroy similar level of spores of bacteria, but UHT is better in terms of maintaining nutritional value. You do a shorter time, so you change or you damage less nutrients. This we discuss in chapter 6, but however, I just briefly mention here, so you know that UHT, we heat for a shorter time, even at higher temperature, so we destroy a similar level of spore, but we destroy less nutrients. We change less nutrients. And then people can use lactulose content to differentiate, to compare between normal sterilized and UHT milk. And then in UHT milk, the maximum allowed concentration of lactulose is 600 ppm, 0.6%, okay? So UHT milk should have less than 0.6% of lactulose. Normal sterilized milk then can have higher 0.6% because UHT treatment has less impact on nutrient, so less isomerization of lactose into lactulose. Remember here, for UHT milk, people put regulation, this regulation to have lower 600 ppm is not because lactulose is toxic, just to be sure that UHT milk should not have strong impact of heat on the nutrients.